solve question 12. And I'm going to stop here after this question just because we did deal with quite a big question earlier, but let's focus now on what we have here, which is give systematic names. And this one might take a while too. Systematic names to following compounds. Okay? And these are binary compounds, which is so A, B, C, D. We have N2F2, CF4, N2O5, and As4O6. So the way we name these, that first have to recognize something. As we go through them, which is what I'm going to do right now, you notice that all of these are molecular compounds because nitrogen and fluorine, they're both nonmetals. Carbon and fluorine, so this is molecular. Okay, carbon and fluorine, same thing, both nonmetals, molecular. Nitrogen and oxygen, both nonmetals, molecular. Okay, astatine and arsenic, that's what it is. Arsenic and oxygen, both, that's tricky. It's metalloid. We're gonna say that this is, well, let's see. Arsenic and oxygen, let's find out by its electronegativity. 3.44 minus 2.18. Oof, geez. 1.26 difference. We're gonna say this is molecular as well. There may be a better name, but we're gonna name all these. Oh, that's metalloids are always the trickiest ones because they're kind of metals but kind of not, so their naming gets a little bit complicated. But we're gonna go with the trend here and name them by like molecular standards. And the key thing about molecular naming is that you want to include the prefix indicating how many you have. Okay, so starting with N2F2, this would be dinitrogen. Difluoride, and you still end with IDE because that is what you do for the second half. You still end with IDE. You always drop the end. It's not going to be fluorine anymore. It's going to end with IDE. So dinitrogen fluoride. Okay, and now CF4, we have carbon, and the naming always applies at least to the second one, but the first one, if there's a number there associated. Okay, in this case there isn't, but if there was, you'd be like dinitrogen, dicarbon, tricarbon, things like that. But here we only have one carbon, so you don't have to. You can say monocarbon, but I would recommend you don't, because the important part is the second one that follows. Okay, so the carbon tetrafluoride. Okay, all right, still the same IDE. And the funny thing is that actually this one is also known as methane, because that would be its hydrocarbon naming rule. Okay, definitely not methane. I thought I was CH4. CF4. This is carbon tetrafluoride. Please don't make the mistake. This is not methane. So with that being said, we have carbon tetrafluoride. This one here, N2O5. This would be dinitrogen pent. Toxide. Okay, and the last one, because we're just assuming molecular, I don't even know this is correct, I'm gonna say it's tetraarsenic. So tetraarsenic, which is a mouthful, tetraarsenic hexoxide. That looks very wrong to me, but what can we do? These are the names we're going with. Let's see how we did. So yes, N2F2, dinitrogen difluoride. Awesome, we got that. Carbon CF4, carbon tetrafluoride. Perfect. N2O5, dinitrogen pentoxide. Awesome again. And now, moment of truth. Arsenic trioxide. I couldn't tell you why. No, really, I can't. What they did here is that they took it down to its, I guess, base, which is this, As2O3, and then they named it. But then if that was the case, we could say this was nitrogen fluoride, which is not true. You can't just do that to anything. And I think this is where it ties into the fact that it's a metalloid, because it kind of follows the... Yeah, you see, it literally is a metal, like a pseudo-metal, because it literally half follows a rule. Because here they dropped the fact that arsenic should have like a dye in front of it, but then they still have the trioxide at the end. Because for ionic compounds, when you name them, you don't even put the... I guess the prefix there at all. Like when you have a good example would be CaCl2. Okay, this is just called carbon chloride. Okay, I mean, whoops, calcium chloride, not carbon. Yeah, this is just called calcium chloride. In fact, if I were to search it up, it'd just be calcium chloride, and you'll see it here, CaCl2. Okay, but if I were to search up, so exactly, right now we have arsenic trioxide, which literally breaks almost every rule we know so far about naming, which makes sense because it's a metalloid, it does what it wants. Unfortunately, this would be one of those you kind of have to memorize, but if I were to type in tetrarsenic hexoxide, it shows up. You see, As4O6. Yeah, so it's a real thing, but if I click this, it calls it arsenic trioxide. So it has multiple names. And it looks like I did spell it wrong, because you should actually have an extra A. I thought you could kind of drop it, but I guess it really likes to be tetra arsenic. So this one I'd highlight because systematic, according to Google, it works for this. You can still get tetra arsenic hexoxide, but its other name is also known as arsenic trioxide. So with this type of question, this is correct. It's just really tricky when you're dealing with metalloids. Those ones, hopefully you don't get those type of questions. But I would treat, personally, I would treat metalloids like just non-metals. Even what I did there when I calculated the electronegativity difference, if it stays below 1.6 difference, to me, that is not going to be ionic. That's a molecular type of bond, if that makes sense. Okay? So with that being said, this is correct, and we're going to solve that, and we're going to actually stop here. So just want to thank you again for joining us this stream. If you have any further questions or want to, you know, explore in greater depth and detail the questions we've gone over, definitely I implore you to check out the links below. Other than that though, you have a great rest of your day, and see you next time.